Hey, I'm Janek Gwizdala, and I'm giving you a quick look inside what our next videobasedlessons.tv course is going to be all about. I had so many requests the last time I sent out a survey, and we chose chords and reharmonization for our current course, but bebop vocabulary was such a close second. That's what our next course is going to be, starting in a few weeks. So I just made a video for my members, a kind of a look into, a preview just for the members. And for the next couple of days, it's going to be up on YouTube for you guys to see as well. After this little intro, it's going to fade straight into the video. So check it out. We're going to be looking at bebop vocabulary. It's not a huge part of what I do, but it was such a popular subject and something I really have checked out a lot. I've had an amazing time going back into some old transcriptions, making some new ones, and kind of relearning a lot of this information and a lot of this vocabulary, and a few pieces of it are rubbing off into my playing right now. So enjoy the video, and I'll see you again soon. Hey guys, Janek Gwizdala here, a little bonus video for you. While you're finishing up our 12-week chords and reharmonization course, I'm hard at work on our next course, which is going to be dedicated to bebop vocabulary. And it's not just a single kind of narrow-minded thing about, okay, we're going to look at bebop. I really want to take a look at A, how I use that. I get a lot of questions about that. You know, what did I check out? How does it feature in my playing? What did it enhance? What did it help me with? So we're going to look at all of that. We're going to look at some specific transcriptions, some Clifford Brown, some Lee Morgan, some, of course, Dizzy Gillespie, Charlie Parker, some of the real greats and innovators, inventors, if you like, of bebop. And then I want to take it to that next step where we look at guys. Let's get some volume here. Where we look at the kind of the next step where it goes from bebop and the kind of bebop elements I hear in more modern improvisers. I'm working on this, as you can hear, working being the operative word. I'm working on this Dave Kokoski solo, the great piano player Dave Kokoski, and there are some things that jumped out to me which are modal, and some things are kind of bebop language. So I want to take a look throughout the course of how we're going from that real old school traditional bebop sound, vocabulary, time feel, into some things that mix both modal and modern sounding stuff and the old school. I'm working on a lot of things which I'm going to encourage you to work on throughout the course, throughout the 12-week course. I just have kind of a 5 chord here in the key of G because I'm working on this Clifford Brown solo. From Pent Up House, Sonny Rollins, Clifford Brown, Pent Up House. I just have it over a 5 chord right now because I'm working on some elements of that solo, learning them. I should probably be doing it a lot slower. And then, you know, mixing that with my own vocabulary. So just working on. So some beboppy things and stuff that I'm kind of bringing back into my conscious, back into my playing for the purpose of this course, and having, as you can tell, having a lot of fun doing it. And then really trying to have, you know, the way my practice routine is laid out to really assimilate some of this information. You know, a couple of these solos we're going to be looking at are new for me. This is not stuff I transcribed 10, 15 years ago. It's some stuff I transcribed specifically for the course. So I'm learning. So yeah, and so etc. etc. I'm learning these new lines, these new phrases, these new elements that I'm getting from this Clifford Brown and Lee Morgan material, and that's my process right there. And I should really be taking it a little bit slower, but in that kind of tempo. And then, you know, it's interesting how long it takes, you know, to really come out naturally in my playing. Of course, I'm working on a lot of this stuff for the purpose of the course to explain this to you guys. I'm not necessarily, the main focus of working on this material isn't to inject it into my playing all of a sudden. I'm not going on a big bebop rant where I just suddenly want to assimilate all of this bebop language. But of course, some of it is going to rub off, and there are some very cool elements that already are. But it's just really amazing how long it actually takes. You know, when you think you have something down at a tempo that... I mean, that actually wasn't too bad with that tempo right there, but the tempo's still a little quick for in terms of actually practicing it and getting those notes and getting them accurate to the point where I could double that tempo, you know. A lot of this bebop stuff, there's some Lee Morgan stuff we're going to look at in the course, which is, it's unbelievably technically demanding. When you look at the notes, you know, the notes and the sequence of notes and the ideas are not necessarily super crazy or angular, but the dexterity with which they're played, you know, and that whole thing of it, of a lot of this stuff being played on a horn instrument, a wind instrument rather, a brass or woodwind instrument, there are some definite differences between my technical ability and I think us as fretted stringed instrument or fretless stringed instrument players. Definitely some differences and some challenges that present themselves. So this is looking at it with Lee Morgan, Clifford Brown, Charlie Parker, Dizzy Gillespie, you know, some of the greats of bebop. That's what we're going to be checking out. And this is how I'm going about it right now in terms of, you know, adding slightly, piece by piece, not trying to, like I always say, not trying to conquer everything in one day, not trying to learn everything at once, not trying to fix all the problems right now, just adding it in. I have this nice little five chord, like a D sus kind of sound, we're in the key of G going, and just kind of going with material that I'm comfortable with, at a pace I'm comfortable with, rhythmic ideas that I'm very comfortable with, and then injecting the new stuff into it as and when I feel it, and not trying to rush it, not trying to force the issue. See, I didn't make it. I kind of went in pretty strong, but just didn't make it. And right now in my process, it's not a moment where I want to stop and go back to that. I just want to let the ideas kind of flow. I'm going to try and play that lick, that idea from the transcription as much as possible, but I really want to let the other ideas flow and come out and see what I come up with. Because it's when I'm jamming like this with the looper, it's these moments, this time, where I can really come across things that I've never played before and really be improvising and finding new rhythmic and melodic ideas. So, I'm So I'm going to play out of this video. I'm kind of getting in the zone here, which is awesome. And it will probably be another 3 hours of doing this. That's generally how my process goes. But yeah, I'll see you guys in a few weeks when we start this bebop course. I can't wait. I'm having so much fun digging back into this style of music, and I'm sure you will do too. So we'll see you in a couple of weeks when we start this course.
Oh,